Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Meenu, and these are the major news stories of Tuesday, December 26, 2023. Israeli forces bombarded Palestinian refugee camps in central Gaza in apparent preparation to expand their ground offensive. In a first, a Hindu woman has filed a nomination to contest in the provincial elections in Pakistan. CPM rejected the invitation to attend the inauguration of Ram Temple in Ayodhya. The temple will be inaugurated on January 22nd. The revenue collection at the Lord Ayyappa Temple at Shabarimala has crossed Rs 200 crore in 39 days since the current pilgrim season began. The Navy has deployed guided missile destroyer ships after missile attack off India's coast. Let's get into the details. The Israeli forces bombarded Palestinian refugee camps in central Gaza on Tuesday in apparent preparation to expand their ground offensive into a third section of the besieged territory, said residents. For weeks, Israeli forces have been engaged in heavy urban fighting in northern Gaza and the southern city of Khan Yunis. This has driven Palestinians into further smaller corners of the territory in search of refuge. Despite international pressure for a ceasefire and US calls for a reduction in civilian casualties, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu on Monday warned that the fight is not close to finished. Israel's offensive has been one of the most devastating military campaigns in recent history. According to the Health Ministry in Gaza, more than 20,600 Palestinians, two-thirds of them women and children, have been killed so far in Gaza. Meanwhile, an Israeli airstrike outside the Syrian capital Damascus on Monday killed a senior advisor in Iran's Revolutionary Guards. As sources told Reuters, the advisor, known as Sayed Razi Mousavi, was responsible for coordinating the military alliance between Syria and Iran. In a first, a Hindu woman named Dr. Savira Parkash has filed a nomination to contest in elections in Pakistan's rusty Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. The elections are scheduled for February 8. Dr. Savira submitted her nomination papers on Friday, December 23, for the general seat of PK-25 constituency of the KPK Assembly from the mountainous Burna district as a Pakistan People's Party candidate. According to her father Om Prakash, she has also filed papers for a seat reserved for women in the KPK Assembly at the request of the provincial leadership of the party senator Rubina Khalid. She will also formally get a party ticket during a PPP rally in Burna on Wednesday, Om Prakash added. According to local politician Salim Khan, who is affiliated with the Kami Vatan party, Savira is the first woman from Burna to have submitted her nomination papers to contest the upcoming elections from the general seat. Savira completed her MBBS in 2022 and is also the general secretary of the PPP Women's Wing in Burna. She is said to follow in her father's footsteps, working for the area's poor. She will also work for the welfare of women in the area to ensure a safe space for them and will help them attain their rights. The CPM General Secretary Sitaram Yechuri on Tuesday declined the invitation to attend the inauguration of the Ram Temple in Ayodhya. As said by the party on X, it holds a belief that religion is a personal choice and is not to be converted into an instrument of political gain. In a statement, the Politburo of the Left Party said Yechuri received an invitation to attend the inauguration ceremony of the Ram Temple in Ayodhya. According to the party, its policy has been to respect religious beliefs and safeguard the right of every individual to pursue their belief. It believes that religion is a personal choice, not to be converted an instrument for political gain. It is most unfortunate that the Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP and the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh or RSS have converted a religious ceremony into a state-sponsored event directly involving the Prime Minister, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh and other government functionaries, the official statement by CPM added. The Ram Temple will be inaugurated on January 22nd with Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. The revenue collection of the Sabarimala Hill Shrine surpassed Rs. 200 crore on Tuesday, stated the Travancore Devasam Board. The initial phase of the two-month-long annual pilgrimage season is approaching its conclusion, culminating with the auspicious Mandala Puja on December 27. As said by the Devasam Board, the temple has received Rs. 204.30 crore as revenue in the last 39 days till December 25. Of the total revenue of Rs. 204.3 crore, Rs. 63.89 crore was contributed by devotees as Kanika, while Rs. 96.32 crore was generated through the sale of the sweet offering Aravana, said TDB President P.S. Krishnath. Sabarimala would be closed at 11 p.m. on Wednesday after the Mandala Puja and would be reopened on December 30 for the Magaravilakku rituals. The Magaravilakku ritual is on January 15, Prashant added. The Indian Navy will deploy guided missile destroyer ships in the Arabian Sea as a deterrent after an Israel-affiliated merchant vessel was struck off the Indian coast over the weekend. The Navy was investigating the nature of the attack on the vessel, which docked in Mumbai on Monday, and initial reports pointed to a drone attack, a Navy statement said. Further forensic and technical analysis will be required to establish the vector of attack, including type and amount of explosive used, the statement added. India was committed to keeping sea lanes in the Indian Ocean region safe and secure for maritime trade, the defense minister said on Tuesday. India plays a role of a net security provider in the entire Indian Ocean region. We will ensure that maritime trade in this region rises from the sea to the heights of the sky, Rajnath Singh said at the commissioning ceremony of another guided missile destroyer ship in Mumbai. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Meenu, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.